Yo, yo, it's DJ Already and my girl.
Flo Milli Shit.
Hey, Flo Milli, man. What's up? What's up? How you doing?
I'm good.
That's what's up. How's it feel to be on tour right now?
It feels good. It feels real good. It's a blessing, sir.
Already. Now, I didn't know. I just found out that you're from Mobile, Alabama.
Yep.
That's what's up, man. So do you think it's like a harder challenge coming out of Mobile, Alabama than other females say when they're from Atlanta or Los Angeles or New York or anything like that?
Yeah, definitely, because it's really not no music scene down there, so it's like a 1 in a million chance that you really make it. And if you do, like, a lot of times they don't really support everybody out there. So I commend anybody that make it out of Mobile, for real, because it takes dedication and hard work.
Already. Now, who are some of your musical influences? Like, coming up, who did you listen to, or who do you think, like, helped shape and fashion the way you flow?
Definitely Young Thug, Nicki Minaj, and Rico Nasty. Like, they're my three favorite artists out right now. And I had to listen to a mixture of a lot of stuff. Like, I listened to Erykah Badu, Jill Scott, just because of my mama and what she came up off of. So, like, it's a mixture of a lot of different stuff.
Already. Now, you've been rapping since the age of what, 11 years old? About 11?
11.
Okay, so that's what, I don't put your age out there, but you, that's about 9 years, right?
Yeah.
Okay, well, I just put your age out there still. But anyway, you know what I'm saying? But what I mean by that is, when did you know, like, after rapping 9 years, when did you know, like, this is it? This is what I want to do. Like, you was like, I'm taking this serious.
Mm-hmm. When I was 17, that's when I really started to take it serious. Like, because when I was 11, I was always in, like, a girl group. But when I turned 17, like, it was just me. Like, I had to decide whether I wanted to keep going or if I was just going to quit because I felt like I needed a crutch or whatever. So, like, when I was in high school, I just started making raps and putting them on Instagram. And that's really how I got most of my fan base. Like, well, not most of it, but that's how I started my fan base. Just rapping on Instagram, putting out videos, and, like, going to the studio, recording songs.
Grinding. So it's safe to say you're like an internet sensation.
Pretty much.
Already. That's what's up. Now, what's your favorite part about being an artist?
The fan love. Like, the way the fans react whenever you perform or you interact with them. Like, sometimes that stuff can, like, really brighten your day, depending on, like, if you had a bad day or something. Like, that's my favorite part of it.
Already. Yeah. Now, what project do you have coming up, and what projects are you doing right now? Like, what you got going on?
Right now, we're working on my first project that's coming out before the summer. And before that, we're going to drop, like, singles simultaneously and hopefully do some festivals if they don't cancel them.
Already. Yeah, that corona. How you feel about the corona?
I don't know. It's kind of scaring me right now.
It's scaring you?
At first, I was joking about it, but now, like, we canceling the promo tour, so it's like, now it's getting real. So.
Yeah, when they canceled the NBA, I was like, oh, yeah, this is for real.
Yeah.
So, can you let the people know all the platforms that they can find you at, where they can search your social media, how they can get your music?
All right. Y'all can find me on Instagram at Flo Milli Shit, or you can follow me on Twitter at _FloMilli. And my music is on all platforms, Apple Music, Spotify, SoundCloud, YouTube. So, yeah, check me out.
Already, man. That's Flo Milli, man. It's DJ Already, and we out.
You say you want this, where the cash at? Before you take my number, send a cash app. Too good for a lab rat. Never hear a broke, say smash that. Keep me fresh, designer on my damn back. Walking through the set, smelling like a damn sack. 30-inch weed, rolling up, Hercules. Make that, give me hip, till he can't breathe. Till his knees weak, till he make it leak. See me in the club, I ain't need to speak. Catch me in the club, Bible. Catch me in the club, Bible with my. Catch me in the club, Bible. Catch me in the club, Bible with my.
Yo, you see who it is, man. Ty Bree, she back here for the second time, man. What's good with it, Ty Bree?
Hey, what's up?
Like, chilling, man. Last time I seen you, I think it was what? It's about to be your birthday, wasn't it? You ready to turn up?
2 months ago.
Already, it's about 2 months ago.
Yeah,
I remember you was sick on Instagram. I think something your package wasn't coming, and you was like, if my package don't come, I'm gonna be sick on my birthday. I forgot what it was. You know what I'm saying? Might have been your due or something like that. You was waiting on it.
I don't know.
So since the last time you been here, man, what's been popping with you?
Same stuff, just moving around, just, you know, working.
Already. Now you got this tour
cracking off. I didn't know this was like a surprise tour to me. I didn't even know nothing about it. I would have been talking to you last time about it. Yeah, like,
it's
so
a
how?
Little promo tour.
All right, how'd that crack off? How did that, you know, get together?
I don't know. You know, my people put it together, my team put it together.
Already, already. Now, were you already in the mix with Mulatto and Flo Milli? Like, did you?
We just work with the same people. So
okay, so it's an RCA thing.
Yeah, we just.
Okay, already, already. So on the, so it's just a on a business level, y'all. You know what I'm saying? That's what's up, man. That's good stuff, man. That's what's up? That's what's up. Well, they said we ain't got too much time with y'all. They ready for y'all to drop y'all stuff, man. So I'm gonna let you go. I appreciate you coming through.
Thank you,
man. Hey, man. Turn up one time.
He gon' catch it. I ain't athletic, but it's tennis for the necklace. Yeah. Hey, where that cash at? I stack it like Tetris. Real gutter bitch, real plugs and connections.
Real.
First I make him eat it till he locked y'all. Give it to him good, knock a nigga socks off. I run it up, they busy running they mouth. I'm a real rich ass bitch from the south. Can't bust down for a bus.
Mulatto, mulatto. What's that name? Does that have a meaning, or what's the meaning behind that?
Yeah, mulatto is actually a racial slur used back in the day for people who got like one black parent, one white parent.
Okay.
So it's just me like flipping the definition and taking that word and creating a new new definition for it, turning the negative into a positive.
Already, that's what's up.
I mean, it's me.
That's
mulatto.
What's up.
So.
That's what's up. So coming up. That was a big thing. How did you face and how did you overcome those obstacles? Because I know it can be a thing when you black and white and you know, it makes you feel like you're in the middle, like you don't belong this way or you don't belong this way. So how did you overcome some of them obstacles growing up?
Yeah, I don't even look at it as like an obstacle. I think people be like mistaking me like when I talk about it. It's not even like me and it's, I don't even look at it as like a quote unquote struggle, you know what I'm saying? Because a lot of people be like, well, that's nothing compared to what we go through or we go through or we go through. And I'm like, it's not to be compared to nothing, you know what I'm saying? It's just me telling my story, living my story, and owning who I am, you know what I'm saying? So it was just confusing as a child, like having one parent that has this type of way of raising their child and their family operate like this and they come from this, just even small things like they cook like this and they act like this, you know what I'm saying? And then you got one family that do the whole complete opposite, like family reunions was different, weddings was different, house rules was different, like, you know what I'm saying? I watched my parents kind of like have disagreements on like parenting, you know what I'm saying? So it's just a little confusing as a child. I don't even look at it as like an obstacle, it's just literally just me.
Already,
you know what I'm saying?
That's what's up. So, the rap game.
Yeah.
Like, you went on there, did your thing.
Yeah.
Like, you know what I'm saying? How was that experience? Can you talk about that experience?
Yeah. TV different. TV different for sure. It was dope though. I don't never discredit it because it definitely gave me a platform. What people don't realize is I did the rap game 5 years ago, so that platform only gets you so far, you know what I'm saying? Everybody who do music and appears on a reality TV show, that don't always mean, oh, you out here.
All right.
You know what I'm saying? So after you are given that platform, you gotta take that and run with it. Like, you gotta take full advantage of it. So I definitely credit it for giving me a platform and to be able to showcase myself, my talent, my music, you know what I'm saying? But from there on, it was up to me.
Already.
You know what I'm saying? So.
Already. That's what's up. So, you originally from the A?
I'm from the A. You want to know something crazy? I was born in Columbus, Ohio.
Oh, you were born in Columbus? That's
Columbus.
What's up.
I was born in Columbus.
Already.
My parents moved from Columbus soon as my mom graduated high school. Mama had me at 15 years old. So, I don't really know much about Columbus, Ohio, whatever, but all my family here, though.
Already, that's what's up. Shout out Columbus, Ohio.
Oh,
in a mess, you know what I'm saying? But so being from the A, like when I usually come around, people from the A is different from people from other cities. A lot of people from the A network and support each other, and it's like a real, it's like a whole circle. Like everybody show love. Do you feel like that too?
Yeah, I ain't gonna lie though. Like prior to me traveling and stuff, like I did not understand what people said, like what they meant when they said that. Like I'm like, what you mean we support each other? We be hating on each other, like, y'all tripping. Until you go to other places, other cities, and you see how hard it is for them to make it out, you be like, well, dang, okay, Atlanta, we might be a little supportive then.
already. I noticed that was different with a lot of cities, man. You know what I'm saying? Like, yeah. They don't even link up with each other. Yeah. They don't see, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah. It's like, hey, y'all. It's like, we don't know how good we got it, really. You know what I'm saying? So, I know.
Already. So, the tour.
Yeah.
How does it feel to be on tour?
Yeah, it's crazy. It's a blessing. I got to stay prayed up and hand sanitizer in pocket.
Already. Corona. The Corona's okay. Here. Corona, yeah. Man, how you feel about the Corona?
I don't know how to feel because, like, you hear something one day, then somebody, you hear something else, and everybody got, like, mixed, you know, feelings on it. So it's like, I don't even know how to feel. Like, I don't know whether to be scared or be like, oh, no, it ain't that serious. Like, I don't
already.
Know. I gotta do more research on it.
Alright, that's what's up. So, can you let people know, like, some of the projects you're working on or for that sure. You're working on in the future?
Yeah, I just dropped Hit the Lotto in December, so we still working that like crazy. B from the South Remix was, B-Word from the South Remix was on it, featuring Sweetie and Trina, so y'all go check that out. EP is called Hit the Lotto. That's going crazy right now, but you know, I don't never take no days off. So as soon as I dropped that, I was already back in the studio working on something else. So the next project coming soon already. So
that's what's up. That's what's up, man. So can you let the people know all your platforms where they can find your music or keep up with you?
Y'all follow me on all social media at Mulatto. That's MULATTO. Twitter, Facebook, YouTube, Instagram, all that. Mulatto.
That's what's up, man. We out with Mulatto's DJ already, man. Holla. Appreciate it.